putting a flat emblem on a Mercedes that came with a standing hood ornament. This video is not discussing which one's better or which one looks better. This video is just to give out information on which flat emblems work really well and which ones don't. So cars like the W210, the W124, 202, 208, 211, any of those era cars came with the standing star like this, and they're all, I believe, identical because it has this blue Mercedes logo right here, the blue and chrome, and the standing star, which can move and pivot. So pretty much none of those cars from that era ever came with option for a flat emblem. The only exception I can think is the W209. While that car pretty much always had a flat emblem, it shares the front end with a C55, a 203. So that is one exception to that rule. However, Mercedes does make a factory part for the flat emblem, but it does not fit these cars perfectly with the standing star. So you might be asking yourself, why does the factory Mercedes part not fit really well in these cars? And that's because of one of two reasons. The first reason is we'll see that the hood is curved, so it's not perfectly flat. These flat emblems do not match the curves of the hood. They do curve a little bit, but not enough, or in some cases too much, depending on the car. And the second reason is this little circle piece right here is too big on the factory piece. This is 45 millimeters. While on the factory one, it's about 57. All right, so if we measure the emblem at the base, so we'll see it's almost 45 millimeters, which is about the exact size of the base. So the way the factory hood emblem works, and this is not a factory one, but it will look like this, except it is bigger. This is 45 millimeters. The factory one will be 57. And on the back, it will not have this bolt coming out, but it will have a clip. So it's a spring-loaded clip that you compress to get in and out, and you just put on the car like that. But when you do, it does not sit flush. It will sit on top of the hood and it will go over the actual indentation for this emblem. To remove the standing emblem, it is really easy. So just start by popping your hood open. So once your hood is popped open, we will see that the emblem is right here. So this is really simple. You will try to grab this piece by your fingers, and if you can't, you can use tools. So a tool that will work good is an open-ended wrench or a pair of needle-nose pliers. The pliers are probably better. But you can find this wrench in your toolkit in most of these cars. So you just have to kind of line it up there and you twist it. Okay, so the way you twist this clip is you twist it counterclockwise. So we'll grab it and twist it. And now it's unlocked. So now we will carefully lower the hood. Okay, we'll see that the emblem is loose. So now we will twist. And carefully get out of the way. We gotta line that up with the opening. And that's it. Okay, I just wanna show this out of the car. So this is the unlock position. So this is how you insert it in the car. So we will see that the clip is right here on the front. And that is how you insert this in the car, like that. So once it's in there, you twist it clockwise. And that is the lock position right here. These will lock onto underneath the hood. And see on the factory part, there is this blue tape to protect the paint underneath. So that is unlocked when you go all the way. Don't push too hard because this clip can fall off, and that's locked. So that's all there is to it, to the factory one. And we will notice similarities in design between these two. So this is the flat one that I prefer, the 45 millimeter, and they look pretty similar. It'll probably be a good idea to put some blue tape underneath this to protect the paint. And here's the difference between the two. When you do buy these brand new, it comes in three pieces. So you see, I have two here. This actual Mercedes emblem will be a sticker. So there is adhesives on the back of this. And then there's this receiver end of it, which is this entire metal thing. So what I do usually is, I already applied the sticker, but I'll insert this first. You line this up to where the locking position is. So if we're facing the car, this is unlocked, that's locked. And you tighten it down. So you just screw it until it's tight. And then I apply the emblem, and that way I could try to get it on straight, and if not, I can loosen this and make some adjustments. But that is how easy it is to put on. This is what the hole looks like. You'll see there's notches on the front and the back. That is how the factory emblem inserts, and then that's how you twist it to have that clip be on the left and right, so it locks into place. Okay, so before we insert this emblem, we will start the threads off the car, and then this way we can get this in easily and then line this up. So bringing the hood down, we will line up that clip and line up the emblem, and we can make our final adjustments at the end, but we'll just get started for now. So we will go underneath and we will twist that clip to be on the left and right. All right, here's the final product. I got on there as straight as I could. So the thing is, when you're putting this on and you're finally tightening it, you have to keep wiggling this around until it sits perfect and you line it up to how you want it to be straight. So I think I got it pretty straight. So wiggling that kind of messes with that clip, but as long as you get on there almost all the way, you'll be good. And you just tighten it down by hand and it'll be on there fine. So here is the finished result. And we'll see if it fits really well. It's inside that indent, it's not over it. So we'll see if it's nice and flush. And I really do like this black emblem. It works on a black car like this. They do make the blue emblem, and of course they have all the AMG and other tuner brands like Brabus and stuff, but that's all personal preference. I'll link some I find in the description. These are not the easiest to find, these aftermarket with the twist on, but they do look the best. This is one of those rare instances when using aftermarket parts are better than factory parts. So when you do use that factory flat emblem, it'll stick over the paint and it'll create this marring on the surface right here. It will cut into the paint. So you'll have a circle here if you ever decide to take it off. With this, it sticks in the factory location and it's fine. So that's all there is to it, to switch from a standing hood ornament to a flat emblem on your Mercedes if it came with the standing hood ornament. So if you have any questions, please feel free to leave them below, and thank you for watching.